This is Sky recording live from Twitch TV. We're kicking back off. We got some of our game world done, and we're just going to continue on. We've got a bit to cover, and I want to get through a lot more of the game world. We've got pieces of it done, but not all of it. So let's continue on. So where did we left off at adding the game object. Looked like we're going to do the move to, which we did. So we need to do a couple of sanity check things real quick, which is making sure that if we pass in null or anything like that, that we catch it and make sure we don't crash out or anything like that. So what we're going to do is I'm just going to quickly write those, say test should not add entity to world if null. Get that quickly out of the way. So I'm going to say game world add game object null world point. And now we can say, kind of just don't want it to crash, but I wonder, we are returning the game objects, so we should be able to say assert equal game zero game world game objects. Is that a list? Guess it's sort of appropriate, because we do want to add. So var object counter 0 I in 0 through, sorry, game world game objects. All right, so we make sure our object count is 0. So object count plus. Oops. And it crashed. That's what we wanted. Superb. Alright, so let's get this added to our nice little world here. Okay, if world entity is null, return there we are. And we need to make sure that we check this too. We'll just say like private inline, private function get game object count. And we'll just take this out here. Object count. And now we get the game object count here. And then we'll make sure when we add the game object that we assert that we have at least one. So we should still have passing tests. I'll put the light on here. It's a little gloomy. Alright, so here we go. 0 is not equal to value 1. Oh, because we're popping it. So we need to do that. How you guys doing today? I hope this is coming together for you. I hope this is making sense to people. I know sometimes I can move quickly. Sometimes I may not explain things real clearly. Just let me know, and I'll go back over it. And just ask me in the comments on YouTube. You can chat with me on Twitch. And and I'll answer them. This is for you guys. Like, I don't, you know, like, I want to build it for everyone online. I want people to understand how this works. I want people to think through game building, and understand, like, the life cycle of it. And, you know, I want everyone to be better developers, better game devs. We want better games, right? So I just want to set up the tools for you guys can build these games, and, you know, and be excited about them. I love building games. I love building let's see, adding to the world. I love building games. And so I want you guys to enjoy it with me. And I want you to feel like you're improving, you know, games and coming up with the ideas you want that don't crash or behave bizarre in certain ways. Like, I want you to guys have really, really cool games. I like playing games. So should not enter to the world if Entity Factory returns null. So anything I can do for you guys, let me know. I'm here for you. I want everyone to be building great games. So I'm just going to clip this off here because we know this part works. But instead of the Entity Factory returning a display, oops, that was a funny key combo. We return null there. And we don't need that. We don't need this. Just keep it simple. And then we just need to do this. This will crash because I know we're not checking for that. There we are. And say here, if display is equal to null. And also, like, let me know on Twitter. Let me know on Twitch. Let me know anywhere. If there's anything you want me to build in particular, if there's any questions you have, if you say, hey, you know, I know that building the game world is important and all, but could you build this? And yeah, I'll consider it, and I'll likely build, you know, what you guys want. So feel free to join in. This is not a you watch me. This is let's build it together thing. So should not move null entity. So join in, please. So we want to do this. We don't want that. Yeah, we can do this. Okay, so what it needs to do, move item to world point. And basically we don't want it to crash. So there's really no way to assert that. I think what we want to do is we want to check our message event. If there is a way to track an exception. I think we could just do this. Let's try it. Try. If that just does an exception, we're going to fail. Insert. Fail. Should. Can't move null game object. Null entity. Okay. And this one's going to be assert. Is true. Let's see if that does the trick. Does not do the trick. I think it's because we check for the display is null. So I think if we do this, that'll crash. also catch the exception. So we're safe on that one. Okay. Test should not move entity with null world point. So we're going to do this one. No, not that one. We want this guy here. Boom. And so here we're going to send through a null should not add entity null world point. That crashes, or world point is equal to null. There we go. Making it better. Killing it on tests. So now we need to do what we had before. Should not move entity with null world point. So there we go, world point. And I think we want to do this again. Instead, we're going to have the game object. Okay, so a little bit like boilerplate stuff. This is all making sure that we sanitize our input coming into our game so we don't get random crashes. And so sometimes it could feel a little tedious, but it is necessary to kind of add these things in and make sure that our game doesn't crash over nulls. That's just like the worst way to crash. Generally speaking, if you get a null pointer, the game just shuts off and there's nothing more distractive to your gamers if the game just turns off. If you get an error message, not so bad, but game just turning off, that feels like you went to take one less step at it, you know, feeling like you're on the ground floor and you have another step and you just fall. Best way I could put it. So let's remove the game object. And I thought of something last night with our object creator. It only creates instances. You also want to dispose instance. And so we have everything being controlled in our object creator. So I'm going to add this real quick. Okay. Object factory test. So now we're going to be controlling not only the creation of all our objects, but also the destruction of our objects. And we can actually override this later. So this is why I'm setting it up this way, is I'm thinking way in the future here. And you can also override this object factory, which we'll probably end up doing at some point. I wonder why. I think it's not picking up my SDK. So when we have full control of our objects, we can create pools, we can recycle our objects, we can control the creation of our objects as much or as little as we need to. And so it'll just make our game run faster. And we don't have to worry when we're building the game all those details of how we're going to create the objects and how frequently create them or whatever. We got something that's actually managing them. And we can be in fuller control. Like, if we want to recycle objects, but somehow we're getting more, like, as we're running the game and testing it, we're getting too many of a particular object, we can whitelist those objects. You say, like, no, we're just going to dispose those whenever. Or we can control, like, we only want 10 in the pool, so if we get more than 10, we'll just start destroying those. So all of that intricate knowledge of how the game works, you don't have to think about it anymore. That'll just be all done in the engine. So I'm going to have that set up. So should dispose, should call dispose on base object. So if it's not a base object, it's basically not going to do anything. But if it's a base object, it'll actually call the dispose function for us automatically. So I'm going to say public var. Actually, you know what? I'm just going to do this. Initialized equals false. And we'll get into more detail on how we're going to make our object factory do these things as the game progresses. So we're going to create this. And we're going to say this. And if you guys have any questions on this, please, please, please ask. I want everyone to understand what's going on here. So object factory dispose instance sample. Oops, I'm pale. And I'm just going to add a second test. Oops. I keep pushing Shift F11. So it's complaining about something should. What am I looking for? Should do nothing on non-base object. Has a different type in core object creator. Oh, it's because I'm void. I think object factory, object creator. There we go. So now we're going to do this. And we're just going to do sample. Oops. There we go. And we're going to dispose it. So we should be able to try this. Insert. Basically, we're just making sure that it doesn't crash. That's true, true. Catch E. Dynamic. Catch any error, essentially. And assert fail should not crash. Let's build that. This should be pretty easy. If we do this, this is going to be object dispose. It's still not working. If that one's the one that's the culprity. All right, I think I need to do this. There we go. And that one passes as well. Okay, so we got that updated, and now we can move on. So I think we actually need to do If we remove... I don't like the idea of... I guess it is a create. We are creating something. I don't like the idea of something being created here and being destroyed by something else. So I'm actually going to dispose view for entity for our entity. Probably too much information for the entity factory, but going to make sure we can, whatever we're going to need is going to be there. It feels like a correct, to me, from what I can tell, a correct API. Dispose of view for an entity, you give an entity any of the display. So I'm going to keep that. I think that makes sense API-wise. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to here and essentially just set this up the same way here, and then we're going to say game world remove game object, and then we should get the entity factory. Dispose view for entity, game object, and the display verify. And it fails, which is what we want, TDD fashion. So we're going to take our entity factory, dispose view for entity, and what we need to do is we need to get this and we're going to add the game object and our display. That should do it. Wonderful. Moving, we're cooking now. So should not remove null game null entity. I gotta stop using the word game object because it's an entity. So I'm gonna set this up the same way. Exactly the same way actually. And this is gonna be null. Dispose for entity is going to be called zero times. So cast any. Hopefully that'll match. So what we want to do is if game object is null, return. So now we can check if our game object is null. We are test. Now we're getting our test, killing it now. Not remove entity if no display is found. Which will never happen. Yes, that could happen. It is found. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're essentially just going to do this and this game object. And it fails. And display is equal to null. Okay. Wonder why that's strange. Okay. So that should pass. Test should remove all entities. I think this one's still called. Yeah, we still got the naming weird. I'll come back and rename this later. That's just a lot of watching me rename. Everything will pass in the end. So what we're going to do is we're going to do this. We're going to set up a loop for it. For I in 10. So we're going to make sure we have 10 of everything. Assert are equal 10. Get game object count. And I'm going to say game world remove game object. Or is it remove? What was it? Remove all objects. I thought. Okay. Remove all objects. And now we're going to make sure that this is going to be 0. And then we need to verify that this gets called 10 times. So we get the dispose happening for everything. It fails. In fact, we got 2 failures. Suppose we've. Tell me that this guy called should. Dispose view for entity. Let's finish this off real quick. Something came back, and this is why I write tests. Should not remove entity if no display is found. Should not remove entity if no display is found. So that did that never pass? I thought that passed before. It was invoked 1 time, expected 0. That's not what I expected either. Interesting. Okay, so let's finish this. What we're going to do is we're going to say for entity in game objects. Ooh, you know what we didn't do? I just realized this. We didn't go to here and assert that what's that function called? Get game object count. We have to assert that that's 0, and that's not happening. There we go. Now we got 3 failures. That's okay. It's all part of the process here. Okay, so where's our remove game object here? So everything seems to check out. So we're going to say the object to display map, remove game object, and then our game objects, remove game object. Okay, so we fixed that one. So now we need to do here, remove all game objects, and say remove game objects. We just need to call that previous function entity. And that should do it for us. As long as that other function is working as expected, and it does, we get what we need. So now we need to come back and figure out why the should not remove null entity if display not found, because it should not be being called. So we get a display node. Oh, that's why it's an and. There we go. This is why we write tests. Sometimes you just make small mistakes. And that would have crashed our game. That would have been a horrible thing. That could have totally crashed our game. So this is why we write tests. I don't know how many times I'm gonna say it, but going to be saying it a lot. Alright, should get display for world entity. I can't stress enough how important testing is. Because all scientists write tests, I guarantee it. And I'm not just saying production tests. That's not the same thing. You don't test a game in production. I don't agree with that. So assert r equal display game world. And look how quickly we found that error. If you were running the game, that could have ran for a really long time before ever finding that. And it would have been really hard to track that down. Get display by game object. Trust me, I've been there with untested games, and it's not fun. It ain't fun at all. Ain't fun at all. Object to display map. Get game object. Now I'm not saying you can't test your game, but I'm going to make sure my game is tested. I'm going to make sure the engine is tested, and all the pieces that go with the engine are tested. Because we can test everything. If we can't test it, it's not very well engineered, and it can't be extendable. So whenever anyone wants to make mods to this game, they'll be able to, and they'll be able to with confidence, because there won't be any strange failures or strange oddities. And if there is, report a bug, never see that bug again. And we'll be creating other new bugs. Well, we could create new bugs. We weren't going to create any old bugs. No regressions. So get this seems kind of like a ridiculous, but we'll make it. Okay, I should get world entity by ID. Seems a little ridiculous to me, but for now, I'm gonna make this actually kind of inefficient. Maybe not. So I'm gonna add the game object like so. Assert r equal game object game world get game object ID, and we're gonna pass it 12. Sounds reasonable, I think. So our game object ID. Oh, it's a string. That's even better. Kind of named identifiers. I like that. Who was thinking when they designed this? 12. Okay. Returned null. So I guess I'll index this. Darn. Especially when I don't have a use case for it. So we'll call it entity index. World entity. So entity index. We're just gonna index it, I suppose. That's how it's gonna go down. World entity. So every time we So this could be a slippery slope. Slippery slope. Really don't like this idea. But I may need it. I thought of it at one point, and we may need it. So we'll just go with it, I suppose. Entity index set world entity ID as a world entity. And then we need to remove this. And entity index get ID. So that should pass. The problem I have with the entity index is not validating that there's only one. So technically when we create the, when we say add it, we're assuming that each one is unique. And I guess that's okay. I guess one thing we need to do is we need to verify that we can't add two of the same entities. Should not be able to add the same entity twice. And that'll help most of the problem. So we add the game object and we're going to do it again. The same one. And so search are equal, this is still going to be one, and this is get game object count. So in this case, we could technically add the game object again or create a new display. We definitely don't want that going on. So here, we're going to check to see if this already exists. Sure. So that'll solve that test. There we go. All right, so this is getting a lot more robust, a lot more stable, a lot more feature rich. Really only have one thing left, and this is a doozy. So there's a couple of ways we can go around about this, and what will likely happen is we're going to do it the slow way first, and then once we kind of get more of our game built, we'll do the fast way. So just double checking everything to make sure we got everything in place. Okay. So the problem with this is that we're doing some sort of spatial comparison. And so this can get really slow really fast, especially when we get a lot of objects on the screen. So it should get entity from world point. And it's also going to require a bit more setup. So I'm going to go up here to one of our more built-out tests here. So they're at, this game object is at world point 83 and 347, but what we also need to add is we need the bounds. And I created this bounds object some time back here, which is their bounds 2D. In fact, it's going to be, that's all kinds of messy, isn't it? Not sure if we want the bounds. In fact, I think we actually want the footprint instead. So we actually want the footprint of the unit. So we don't want to just, they don't take up the world. Well, they do take up the world in a 3D space, but we're only using 2D for now. So we're only looking at their footprint. It could be their entire body, depending if I'm doing a platformer. But if we do a like RTS view, we just want their feet, if that makes sense. So we only want the part of the world that they take up. If we click on their head, it shouldn't matter. We could click on their head, it should matter, but their head doesn't take up space on the ground in this case, or maybe they do. So that's why we're setting up the footprint. We want to know what their footprint is. Bounds is different than the footprint. Their bounds is the actual kind of bounding bubble. That's their 3D space, if we're working in 3D space, or if we're working in space, where our footprint is how much they take in the world. And that's kind of an interesting distinction, especially if there's like a concept of like gravity, you know, something's holding them on the ground. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a footprint print 2D, and I think we're just going to set, we're not going to worry about the registration point for now. So basically, that's for if we want it up left hand corner, middle, whatever. It shouldn't really matter, because all we need to know is we need to know just the footprint. So footprint equals, footprint, which is kind of weird, is a new rectangle. And I want to say they're, their offset is 0, 0. It's kind of hard to imagine a little bit of this. And then their width and depth is 20, 30. So we're making a little bit of a rectangle that they take up in space. So, in fact, we're going to do 30, 20. So it kind of looks like, if we're looking in top down, it's kind of like a man standing facing one direction. That's what they're taking up in the world. Hope we can kind of imagine that, because it's a little weird to sort of imagine. So what we're going to need to do is we're going to say game world get, what is that? Get item at. And we're going to send in a new world point. Do we not have a constructor for this? There we go. Okay, so we're going to send in point 3 and 200 and entity world entity. Did I change the API on that? Yes, okay. We don't need that anymore. And so this is going to be null. Entity. And then now we're going to do the same thing, but we're actually going to tag it. We're actually going to get to that object. Is equal, are equal. We don't get this because that's duplicate. And this is going to be our game object. Okay? And so what we need to do is we need to get the x between 83 and 30 more of that. So between 83 and 113. So we'll just say 100 should hit that guy. And then the pointing at the screen. I'm sure you can see my finger pointing at the screen. This needs to be between 347 plus 20, so between 347 and 367. So we're just going to do 350. So we actually should hit the point of this person, this unit. And for 2D is mad. It's mad. Because I didn't add its var. It's so mad. Look how mad it got. Okay, so it fails as expected because the first test actually passed, which is turned null, which is pretty easy. Because we are returning null. But the second one was not. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a return value. This is going to be a world entity. And for now, we're just going to set to null, so that will cover that case still. Reg though. And the reason this is going to be slow is because we're going to have to iterate through every single object. And figure it out. Later, we're going to implement a quad tree, and then we'll be able to find it a lot easier. Well, not easier, per se. It'd be quicker, performance-wise. And that's what we want. And we definitely don't want to be indexing these. That'd be just way too much indexing. And that'd be hard anyways. It would be hard to index all that and make sure that you're not iterating. You're going to be iterating over it either way. I promise. So, maybe asking as well why I'm actually using a list. I think you saw me kind of go, cringe a little when I said a list. And I said, I guess it's appropriate. Mostly because what this mostly does is insert and remove, and lists are way better performant than arrays at insert and remove. It's just a data structure thing. So for entity and game objects, we're going to get the footprint. Yeah, that should be okay. Entity. Footprint. Now, I think. That's definitely not the right thing. I think I added. We have intersects and contains points, so that's going to be helpful. That's going to be very helpful, actually. We also have a convenient XY, which is nice. So, and it's inlined, so even faster. So I was thinking on that one, I think, hopefully. Was I thinking? Maybe. But sometimes I don't think. So we have our footprint. We also have our entity location, which is the world point. Entity world entity. Is it? It's X and Y. Oh, that's a world point. world point. So we have our location and our footprint. So now, we're going to need to check, we need to create a rectangle for this. So we're going to say bar rectangle equals new rectangle. So we're going to just reuse the same rectangle. So rect x is going to equal our entity location. X. And Z. I think we're actually doing X, Y right now. I think I'll stick with it. It's going to be a lot of, I don't like it. So all our tests are using world point Y. And it should be world point Z. And we need to set our set Y. Oh no, that should be okay. We need our game object set Y to set Z. Z. Okay, that probably broke a ton of stuff, but that's why we have tests. 143. This is the GameWorld 2D. Okay. It probably broke a bunch of tests. Maybe not. Hopefully not. That'd be great if it didn't. I'm gonna just see. I'm gonna see if it's just this not causing it to fail. There we go. It was just that. So we got a ton of failing tests, but that's not a problem, is it? Is it a problem? You let me know if you think it's a problem, because I'm pretty sure I can go here and do that. I bet you that'll fix most, if not all of them. Nope, not even close. Oh, because we had some mocks. Not verify. Wait a minute. They are setting Z. Game object set Z. I think we actually want to do, let's go back, Z here, so we actually want to set Z here, if that does what we need. Getting closer, I think. It says, should get entity from world point, okay. Expected 0, 0. Point. Oh, yeah, that would make sense. World point Z, Z, Z. There we go. See if that gets us back to, there we go. We're back to fixed tests. Okay. Little sidestep there. Told you I'd make that mistake. I think I told you that. Okay. Let's get back to this. Entity location is a world point. The problem is, we need to mock this out. I'm going to say game object footprint returns footprint. And then this is actually kind of irrelevant. So what we're going to need to do is game object world point returns new world point 2D 83347, and that should keep us from crashing. There we go. So that keeps us from crashing. So our rect y is going to be the entity location z. And then our rect width is going to be our footprint width. Footprint width and height, and say if, which we need to create a new point, our point equals new point. Point dot x equals world point dot x and world point z. If rect contains, we could just do this. That's better. So if it contains that point, return our entity. This might be hard to debug if we don't get it right away. Footprint has no field width. Well, what does it have? It is footprint. Maybe footprint rectangle. Footprint. And it passed. That is awesome. Footprint rect. Didn't change that, which is kind of a bummer. So there we have it. We've got it. Wow. Okay. That's fantastic. Everything works. Don't you love it when everything works? This is the best. Okay, so I love it. Let's clean this up. And we're going to say get status. And we have, that's all of our stuff we changed. So you're probably wondering why we're not gonna do the playground right now. It's because it's actually not hooked into anything. We don't actually have an entity factory generating objects. And I think that's the only thing we don't have. We're not building any wizards to our display, so we're kind of in a not very playful state yet. I mean, basically if I run our playground right now, we're just gonna get what we always had. So I'm just gonna commit this. Finished 2D game world. Good. Push origin master. We'll get to play a lot tomorrow, I think. And then we're going to tag this 2015. Oh, 2015. This is 03. What the hell did I just know? 03:23. At 8:33. Git push origin. There we go. All right. We burned through it big time. Let's go to our live game. And we should have our master, which shows our finisher 2 doing a game world. And we should have our tag, which is great. All right. We did it. Congratulations. We are one game world closer to creating a video game. You guys have a great afternoon. Add some comments down on YouTube if you have any questions, anything at all, let me know. And let's continue making games, and have a happy game-making day. See you guys later.